use data then bring people on. So yes, it was, as Fiona suggests, it was an initial target that was set for us without really having that background in this particular field. Clearly what we have to do for next year is look at what would be a reasonable growth area for us to see these expanding next year. Hopefully we get more people on. Thank you, Chair. On behalf of Joe Bob, this is just to explain, this is the revenue monitoring for January. This report is regularly monitored by Cabinet and seen by members of Cabinet. What I can tell you again is that this was the January one. The important key area is actually on page 99, which highlights the underspend that is being looked at by the Director of Resources. And obviously, this is a January. Clearly, our accountancy colleagues are now working on month 11. The expectation is that the overall underspend will have increased, which is obviously to be good for the local authority. And clearly, as obviously today is April, the work will then, once they've cleared month 11, they will start looking at working at month 12, which is actually a much longer process because that is the year end. There are areas of this report that are directly my areas, but clearly we'll try and take any questions that you have with regards to those.
A general question, because we're not in the know. The opening paragraph talks about the money that the council took from balances to do the work at New Brighton during the inclement weather. Has there been any updates? Have we received a full work refund from the government as promised, or is it going to be? First page 95 refers to clean up. So we've given that in that. As you know, a notice of motion was moved in council, and there have been repeated efforts to get the full pension, which is promised, that source of promise. I'm just wondering whether that's going to be managed now by the central government.
Through you, Chair, I don't have the information, but I've got the final information and pass it to members of the committee as to where that currently is up to. Feedback from this year is that because there has been a lot more task work
which we're here being taken, has been the observation that there is drawn both offset and the capacity. So just imagine how we can kind of take that forward and learn from the reviews that we'll be taking as a suggestion for that particular review. The second one is in relation to quality assurance of the reviews committee. And this was something that was raised at the meeting in January, which would be about the committee if you have a look back at the previous reviews on the table, just to look at the sort of approaches that have been used, what have worked well, and what were things that could be highlighted in terms of good practice, to look for a consistent approach and for scoping out future reviews, to ensure really that we get the most out of setting objectives and the most out of the time we put into that work internally. The third one is to review the consistency of development recommendations. This also crops up on the next report, but we also expressed concern really about recommendations, particularly from schools and reviews. The tracking of those and the implementation and the reporting back on progress against that as part of regular reviewing by this committee. So this will be looking at how recommendations are best formed, but again to ensure consistency, because recommendations for those who attended the training that Hannah did from the Centre for Public Schools, he did set out what is a good recommendation, what's a poor recommendation, and how the tracking of recommendations can really kind of add more value to what we achieve in terms of the details scrutiny review work. And the fourth one is reflects the growing role of the constituency committees, the recognition that more decision making is likely to be devolved to those committees. And it's just really how scrutiny begins to interrelate with those committees and how potentially how future decision making by those committees is scrutinized. So I'll finish there. Not
questions, Chair. Just comments.
Thank you.
I'm pleased that I see this because I think at the start of the year when we had our very first meeting, we were all at sixes and sevens a little bit, not quite sure what our role was going to be throughout the year. And this kind of has really tied together all the discussions we've had over the series of meetings and pointed a way forward that's very interesting. So, welcome.
The other work programs for the other three policies. response to the implementation of recommendations, and we need to track those to demonstrate the value of the recommendation and the impact the scrutiny has in terms of recommendations being endorsed, and then what happens as a result of those being implemented. And so this seemed like the obvious vehicle really through the work program to put that section in, and for it in the future to be the mechanism for reporting back the recommendations that were approved through the work of this committee. One was in relation to, it's really the IER, the individual electoral registration scrutiny review that took place earlier this year, which reported to the 15th of January committee. And we are too early actually to report back on those recommendations. They're likely to, the appropriate time is likely to be in the municipal year on June, July, when that initiative really starts to get some momentum. So I suggest that that report back is provided then. But what the recommendations tracker allows us to do as well is to actually program across the year. So what we're intending to do next year is that every recommendation arising from the scrutiny review should have a clear date by which it should be completed. So what that will give us is a schedule across the year which we propose to allow the regular reporting in terms of the program, so that for each one of those got a full plan of what recommendations should be completed. So just draw your attention obviously to the appendices which set out the different work programs for all four policy and four committees. We have got those in three columns because we did feel it would be easier to read on that form. And also just finally as well, appendix 5, which was a note from, we had a meeting with chairs and vice chairs to review progress really with the new approach to scrutiny, the new arrangements for scrutiny. So again, to inform the discussion, which we just about that and to illustrate the discussion that is held and some of the proposals for how and some of the learning to take forward into the municipal year.
Is there any more comments or questions? The other view is the way programs for the other committees. One thing that strikes me is how far scrutiny has come on in the civil policy in the past 12 months. I think the approach is much more consistent, and it's particularly pleasing to see there's a much cross-party work on the task finish groups. And I know yourself and Adam are involved in the task finish group on FOI, the FOI performance, Digital Transformation Resources, and I really enjoyed it. I think compared to where we were,
just one question, I'm not sure whether we're missing something. Page 166 at the top, you've got all the headings, but there's no information. Is that just a bit of a blip with photocopy?
Yeah, apologies, that's just it's an Excel document and it just formats it like that, so they're the headings at the top, it just replicates them.
So if there are questions, can we go to the recommendations on 62? 16.1, agreed? 16.2, agreed?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. I've not been notified of any issues for the business. There's no exempt information. As this is the last this municipal year, I'd like to thank you all for your attendance, contributions, and I'd like to thank officers for the support and the lot of our students on the day for the